Hello guys, I'm Ritesh and today I will show you how you can integrate a 3D design in any of your websites. Okay, so first of all, why should you care about a 3D design or you know a 3D component? If you are a fresher or if you are looking for a job and if you are making your personal portfolio, a 3D design, a 3D component will help you to stand out from other. Okay. Other than that, like if you have a company and you want to showcase your products, so it is also a very nice way to show your products. Okay, and other thing is it's very easy to integrate a 3D design nowadays in modern frameworks like Next.js and all. Okay, so let's create a hero section and we will use Spline for our 3D designs. Okay, so let me show you. You can go to your spline.design. This is the website, you can just log in. Okay, this is also a very cute design. You can see how cool it looks, the little interactions and all. Okay, so these are very easy to make in Spline. In their community section you will find a lot of designs, a lot of pre-built designs. Okay, I'm gonna use this. I will clone this. Great. Okay, so first of all, I'm gonna delete this background, this too, and I want the angle like this. I don't want this gradient. Okay, so I also don't want the rounded borders, and yes, so I don't want this. I guess that will look good. Okay, so yeah, a little bit of editing, and let's create a Next.js application. Okay, npx create and here next app. Okay, so it will ask for the name. So 3D hero section, we'll use TypeScript, we'll use ESLint, we'll use Tailwind, src directory, the app router, yes, import aliases, yes, and yes. Okay, so we are good to go. It is using npm, leave it. We will use tnpm, hero section, tnpm install. Yes, so it is installed. Let's open this. Okay, we'll close this. Here is the design. Great. Okay, so let's run the project. Let's unlock those 3000. Okay, so we will create a mobile first design. So in the src app page, we will remove the entire code. Okay, so let's have a single div and say hello. Okay, so great. global.css and nice. So this is just a hello world. Okay, so for integrating a 3D design we will use a library. Okay, first of all you have to export this. I'm gonna use 100% export, play settings, page scroll no, cursor default. Everything will be normal. I don't want on hover right now. You can like try this too. This is also a cool setting. Just update the public URL. Okay, so yeah, you will have like different ways to you know use this and try to run. For Next.js, what you can do is you can use a package. The name of the package is Spline tool React Spline. Okay, PNPMI Spline tool / React Spline. React hyphen Spline. So we installed the package React Spline Spline tool / React Spline. So we will use this, and the integration of the 3D model will be done in a sec. Okay, so first of all, let's create a components folder. Okay, let's create a components and header.tsx. We will create a header. Okay, great. So we already have Tailwind installed. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have flex padding x8, padding y3, justify center. Not center, I want to justify between. Okay, and this is okay. So the design is a robo. Okay, so we can like create a hero section describing that we have a SaaS product, and the robo is visualizing AI, and we are featuring some AI tools and all. So yeah, we can have a design like that. Okay, so I want the font to be bold, text 3xl, flex, justify center, and items center, and here we can write AI robo. Okay, let's import this header. Okay. Oh, it's not running. Okay, great. And we can add some side sections too. So yes, I want PG black, flex padding x2. I will have first of all three sections, about, and here we can have work, we can have join us. Okay, so yeah, first of all text white. Okay, I want g white padding x3, padding y2. Okay, and flex justify center, item center. So it's gonna be about. Okay, padding x2. We can have padding left 6, space x to be 6, justify between, and padding y to be 2. Okay, so this looks good. Now we can have like some text around here. Okay, yes, so let's create a dev and explore our SaaS platform for the best. I'm gonna have the width to be 70 VW. Text will be 40 pixels. Leading. Okay, so let's have another dev. Right, AI services. Right, we have a tag over here. Okay, let's have a class name. I want this to be a little bit big. Text 80 pixels. Leading none again. Text will be black. Padding x will be 8. Okay, here the text will be gray. And 600.
padding x will be 8, padding top will be 50 pixels. Okay. Okay, so here it is, text. Yeah, so nice. Now we will import our 3D model. Here we will import spline from spline tools, React spline, and we will add spline, and we will use scene, and we will just copy the URL. Okay, this URL. Okay, so it is giving me error. I have to use client. Okay, so you can see the interaction and all, like with my mouse. Yeah, it looks cool. Okay, let's also give this a height of, I guess, 80 for TV height. Cool. You can also create a section. I'm gonna create a section.tsx. NFE section. I'm gonna import this particular section. I'm gonna use it here. And okay, so yes, let's have this section in black. Okay, so I want width full, the background to be black, padding x 8, padding y 8, and leading to be none. Okay, yes. Let's also have few texts in it. Design and development. DEVELOPMENT. Okay, so the class name. Text gray 400 and the text size will be 40 pixels. Okay, and here I want the text to be white and text size to be 60 pixels. Okay, yes, and I'm gonna have another div here. I want the background white. I'm gonna create a button. Okay, so padding x will be I guess 8, padding y will be 3, flex text will be of 50 pixels. Okay, so here we have join us. It's gonna cover the whole width. I don't want that. Okay, so I'm gonna wrap this around another div. Okay, and I'm gonna have class name flex justify between and margin top. I need some margin, it will be 10. I'm gonna have another div, so yeah, here it looks good. Okay, and I'm gonna use an SVG. Let's go to svgbox.net. Let's explore some icon sets. Arrow bright. Okay, so I want this to be 60 pixels. This also. Okay. So class name flex justify center items center, similar for this SVG2. Okay, and we can have a little bit of padding. Okay, margin top is 10, padding y is 3. Okay, I mean, you can have like few more sections. You can create like you can create parallax after this. So yeah, the hero section is almost ready and it's looking good. This is like a very basic and a very starter thing, but you know, we integrated a spline design, a 3D interaction, and yeah, we created a very cool hero section in just 5 to 10 minutes. Okay, so that's it. Baby, you